The problem is that if you won't talk about business with them, someone else will. Hey everybody, Jay Pitts here, broker owner of RE/MAX Premier Properties, JT Pitts and Associates. And today we're back for another episode of JTP University. And it's, I think, very appropriate right now that we discuss something I like to call the Ford technique. You know, it's the time of year where most of your clients are considering selling, getting their home on the market. Spring is about to, you know, be in full effect. We are short inventory in a serious way, and this is pretty much the truth all across the country. So right now is the time where you should be talking to your database, you should be talking to your past clients, anyone in your network that might have a referral for you, that might have an opportunity to grant you a listing that the market desperately needs. Somebody that you may not have even had communication with recently, but you need to kind of have that mea culpa kind of conversation. So the Ford technique is the exact way that you should lead into these conversations. I always say that 99% of agents never call their network. Of those, 99% never talk about business. If you want to be the top 1% of 1%, you need to be able to have a way, a dialogue, a fallback. You need to have comfort around these interactions that lead to business. You're fortunate to be in an industry that everyone has an opinion about, that there's widespread knowledge of, that almost everyone aspires to, which is homeownership. You know, interior design, home flipping, investing, all of those things are cocktail conversations, cocktail party conversations, things that the regular Joe or Jane always has the willingness to discuss. But you have to learn how to open the conversation. Ford technique is how you do it. Of course, it's an acronym. Ford stands for family, occupation, recreation, and dreams. It's four topics, four headings that almost everyone is willing to talk to. It's a passive conversation. It allows you to stay surface level, open conversation, get people comfortable with you, have them, you know, kind of feel at ease around you, build rapport. You have a good back and forth. So it could look something like, hey, Seth, you know, it's been a while since we talked. You know, how's the family? Good open-ended questions are how you start. Hey, how are things going at work? Occupation. Recreation. You know, I saw on Facebook that you bought a new boat. You guys going to the lake a lot this summer? You know, dreams. Hey, you know, last time we spoke, you mentioned you were thinking about getting, you know, a house down in Florida to kind of go to in the summers. You made any progress toward that? How's it going? Any of these individual statements, questions, interactions allows you to show care, to show empathy, to show appreciation for the fact that you play a role in these people's lives. You don't come off like you've got the dreaded commission breath saying, hey, have you thought about selling? Although I am a proponent of that question in the right situation. But again, these are conversation starters. At that point, your charm, your ability to communicate, your ability to make friends and have just person-to-person connections and build rapport has to take over. And the one thing that I really, really want to underscore here, because a lot of you say, you know, Jay, I get what you're saying and I can do that, but it seems disingenuous because, you know, they feel like I've got like the arm, one arm behind my back, and it's like the Looney Tunes cartoon where I'm hiding the mallet and I'm just going to hit them over the head with when are you going to sell later? And I empathize. I understand where you're coming from. The problem is that if you won't talk about business with them, someone else will. Remember, just in Louisville, there are over 5,000 real estate agents. There is someone willing and ready to have an adult, thoughtful, business-oriented conversation with your clients if you don't. That's the first thing to understand. The second thing to understand is you don't have to initiate business in most cases. If you have the Ford dialogue, they know why you're calling. It's a social agreement, okay? They know why you called. They know why you reached out. If they like you, trust you, they appreciate you, they're going to make it easy on you and pivot to business for you. Now, I went over in some recent podcast episodes some fallbacks if it doesn't happen, but just please do me a favor. Pick up the phone, make the call, use the Ford technique, and let them do the heavy lifting for you. Once again, Jay Pitts, broker owner, RE/MAX Premier Properties, here for another episode of JTP University. Hope you find it useful. Feel free to subscribe. Give us a review. We can always use more. We appreciate you, and we'll see you next week.